Hey there, geeks and geekettes. I'm gonna rank the Star Wars franchise. Oh yeah. I love Star Wars. I don't collect that much Star Wars because I collect so much other stuff that I can't afford to. But Star Wars was the first sort of pop culture thing I was aware of as a kid. It was something that I watched with my grandfather every Saturday, and then I'd watch it again with my dad every Sunday. We wore the tapes out. Just absolutely loved these movies. Even the worst of the Star Wars movies are not as bad as some other movies out there. So, without further ado, let's break into that list. Number 11, bottom of the list, with good reason, Attack of the Clones 2002. The Jango Fett fight is fun. Ewan McGregor is excellent as Obi-Wan Kenobi. The budding love of Anakin and Padme is boring as hell. One of the greatest sci-fi villains ever, or future greatest sci-fi villains ever, is reduced to a moping, creepy, shitty teenager. Portman looks bored, and I was bored. Just didn't like this film that much. Yoda and Dooku was cool, but all in all, very boring movie with some cool parts. Number 10, Phantom Menace 1999. Actually, no, I'm swapping those. Jar Jar fucking Binks. This movie's number 11, but it's the Phantom Menace from 1999. I hate Jar Jar Binks. Kid Anakin annoying. It's way too heavy on the CGI. Everything looks fake and false and cartoony. It just didn't look right. I mean, I understand at the time it was cool, but it didn't age well. I don't think it looked cool then. Not for me. I think the practical effects of the original trilogy were far better than what this CGI shit they tried. The pod races were fun and very enjoyable. I did enjoy that. Darth Maul and his double-bladed lightsaber. That was awesome. Him taking on Qui-Gon Jinn and Obi-Wan Kenobi. That fight was near perfect and probably one of my favourite fights of all of the movies. Yet they killed off the second coolest looking villain in the series in his first outing. There is no way should they have killed Darth Maul that early and that easily. Just sort of ruins what was already a really shit film. It's not great at all. Number 9, The Last Jedi. Snoke is wasted. Luke is a miserable old git with a very odd sense of humour, and it's jarring because his character has changed so much. Doesn't sit right for me. Then there's Leia with a Mary Poppins y'all bit from Guardians of the Galaxy. It didn't make any sense. I know she was force sensitive and they could explain that, but what she pulled off there is some magic shit, you know? Something that Luke wouldn't have been able to do after training with Master Yoda. Now, obviously the later films showed that Leia proper trained as a Jedi, so the later film tried to undo the mess that this film was. Luke's ending was very weak. He literally phoned in his final battle, and that didn't sit right with me. The throne room scene was perfection. The cinematography on that was out of this world. It looked absolutely stunning. Kylo, Rey and Finn, they carry this movie well. With a bad script, they do what they can and they make it almost enjoyable. And they make it better than the two previous movies on this list. And also a highlight was Benicio del Toro's character. I mean, he was great. Really liked that character. And I can't wait to see what they do with him. I mean, the next film after this, they've got this awesome character that could be a villain, he could be a good guy. Let's see what they do with him. And then it won't make that entire side quest useless. Ah, they did nothing with him in the new film. So that reduces half hour of this film to being a waste of time. But the Salt Planet dogfight with the red sort of dust, that looked spectacular. And despite how much I'm saying I didn't like this film, I kind of did. There were some really cool elements to it, but they ballsed up Luke Skywalker, and that doesn't sit right with me. Number 8 on the list, Solo from 2018. The film that Mrs. Geek fell asleep watching in the cinema. And I suppose that says enough about it, but I actually liked it. The main issue is that Alden Ehrenreich, something like that, he doesn't have the swagger to pull off Han Solo. He doesn't have the swagger to pull off Han Solo. He's not a patch on Harrison Ford, and you can't see this character growing into Harrison Ford's Solo, and that lets the film down. On the other hand, Donald Glover plays Lando Calrissian perfectly, and you can see him becoming Lando. You can see him growing into becoming Lando. So this spin-off of the scruffy nerf herder, it surprised me. Did I want and need this origin story? No. Did I enjoy it? Yeah, it was a fun ride. And I don't dislike any of these films from this point in. The next film, number 7 on the list, which I assume this will get some heat, is Revenge of the Sith, the 2005 movie. It's by far the strongest of the prequels. Anakin going dark was pretty awesome, although I probably shouldn't have laughed when he killed the younglings. That scene played out far funnier than it should have. I genuinely laughed. Christensen and Portman, they do a far better job than they did in the previous movie. Portman is actually acting. McGregor is as great as he always is as Obi-Wan Kenobi, and really enjoyable. There is questionable dialogue in this movie, but it's not laughable like the previous prequels before it. Yet this is, it's a satisfying entry into the franchise. The Yoda fight scene is epic. The Emperor's cheat and death speech is awesome. I really enjoyed that speech. And after watching it recently, it plays into the last movie of this franchise. It's great foreshadowing, even though it wasn't done on purpose, but it works. Number 6, Rogue One from 2016. The non-Star Wars Star Wars story. There's no real Jedis in there, really. There's not a great deal of lightsaber action, and not that many recognisable characters for a Star Wars movie, yet it works brilliant because it fully commits to being a different movie. It's in this universe, it's very different, it looks different, it's got a gritty look to it, it's got a very gritty feel to it, and this movie becomes a very gritty war movie, and I loved it. A movie that kills off its main cast in the end, or most of it. Did they all die? I think they all die. I can't remember. And it seamlessly joins into A New Hope, and that final scene is chilling. Really, really enjoyed Rogue One. Didn't realise I wanted to watch a prequel in between the prequels. And it doesn't make much sense, but this movie just, it was great. It was a great cast, great looking movie. It made up for some of the lesser movies on this list. Rise of the Skywalker, the ending trilogy of trilogies. Not an easy feat, and a very sticky thing to try and land, yet J.J. Abrams, I think he stuck the landing, especially after trying to clean up the mess that was The Last Jedi. At moments, this movie is breathtaking. Although the Palpatine resurrection goes pretty much unexplained, it's the Emperor that cheats death. He made a speech about it, so I think they can get away with it, from my personal opinion. Rey actually having a lineage, and if you haven't seen the movie, spoilers, she has a lineage, and that sat far better with me than her having no lineage. It puts it parallel to Luke Skywalker's story, where you think he has no lineage. He turns out he's the son of Darth Vader, and Rey's parallel to that, but from a different angle. So I liked it. It's far better than being a nobody. That just sort of sunk. The ending of this movie was surprisingly moving, and there are some real surprises in there. There are people come back for this movie I didn't think would, and yeah, I really enjoyed it. But there is one thing that's really bothering me, and I've only just thought about it. Emperor Palpatine looked like this, yet, because Rey is his grandkid, somebody took one for the team in a major way there. Who? I want to know who the grandmother is. I want to know. So yeah, this movie packs some emotional punches, and it should give hope to everyone out there, because if this guy can get a lead, anyone can. Number four on the list, The Force Awakens 2015, the Disney Star Wars movie that I didn't want, certainly didn't need it, and I thought this was going to be a steaming pile of shit. And then J.J. Abrams somehow got me hooked back into Star Wars. When they announced he was directing, it piqued my interest, because I liked what he did with Star Trek, I liked Lost. And this thing felt so fresh. It was a proper feel-good movie. When you saw the Millennium Falcon, you heard the old noises, everything. It did what the prequels should have been. It reinvigorated my love for Star Wars. And despite it being very new, it fitted in with a classic trilogy. It felt like a classic trilogy movie, which is something the sequels to this didn't really do that well. The new cast worked brilliantly, and I liked the fact that the galaxy didn't become a happy place after they killed the Emperor, albeit short term. The Return of the Jedi, it didn't make the galaxy a happy place. The old characters, they're old. They grew old, they got divorced, they had children, and people sloped off and sulked on islands, and it wasn't a happy ever after story. But the scrapper, the reformed stormtrooper, and the cocky pilot, they pulled this franchise from what was pretty dark times. And this movie just feels great. It proper made the hairs in the back of my neck stand up in the cinema when I first saw the Millennium Falcon in this movie, and the theme music, and really, really enjoyed it. It's also the movie that I nearly went to prison for. Because on my way into the cinema, this little kid walks out, he looks me dead in the face and says, "Han Solo dies, and run." If I could have caught that kid, I would still be inside for what I'd have done to him. Luckily for him, I'm too fat to run. So this brings us on to the top three. Third place, I don't think this top three will surprise anyone, is Return of the Jedi. 1983. As a kid, this was my favourite movie of all movies. I preferred it to A New Hope and Empire Strikes Back as a kid. And I think that's when you know you've become an adult, is when this movie swaps place with my number one pick. So the space battles in this movie, they are mind-blowing. The special effects in this movie for its time were outstanding. The end of the movie, they juggle the space battles over Endor, they juggle the battle on Endor, and they juggle the father and son on the Emperor battle, and then they go back to the ground war between the stormtroopers and the Ewoks and Han and Leia, then back to space, then back to Vader versus Luke versus Emperor, and it never gets confusing. It flows so well, and to me that's how you direct and cut and edit a movie. Brilliant. Vader does the right thing. That is a proper sort of yay moment for the movie. The Emperor gets what he deserves, for now, at least, for a little while. Jabba's palace and everything involved in that was awesome. The pit fight, the Leia taken out. Leia taking out Jabba, everything, the Jabba's boat, it was all great, except Boba Fett. The coolest looking bumbling idiot in the galaxy, but still, I love this movie. Number 2, A New Hope from 1977, or as it was originally called, Star Wars. Where all of this began, in a galaxy far, far away, good versus evil. The special effects for the time, they were groundbreaking, and most of them still hold up today. The space battles don't look any worse today than they ever did. To me, it looks better than The Phantom Menace. That film was so heavy with CGI, it took me out of the movie. The practical effects in this thing, they worked, and as a kid, I was convinced that there were space battles going on. The score by John Williams, it was outstanding, it was bombastic. That introduction with the scrolling words, everything about this movie was just outstanding. The casting was perfect. Ford, he just steals every scene he's in. He chews the scenery. He outshines everyone in this movie. When I was a kid, my brother always wanted to play as Luke Skywalker, and I always wanted to be Han Solo. I thought Han Solo was cool. Vader, he was an intimidating, scary villain. And, you know, Luke was this everyman. He could have been any of us that discovers he's got a higher calling in life. And he battles the ultimate evil. And he saves the day. They save the day. This band of rebels save the day. It's a great space adventure. But where was Chewbacca's medal? Why did the Wookiee not get a medal at the end of this movie? J.J. Abrams, thank you very much for writing that wrong. Number one, and there could only have been one number one for me, and that is The Empire Strikes Back from 1980. This is the movie that would have been my second favourite movie as a kid after Jedi, but as an adult, this is the one that leaps and bounds above any other movie in this franchise. And this is how you make a sequel. Higher stakes, there was controversy. I mean, it was really controversial on its release. There's romance, there's family twists, and the twist that nobody saw coming. There's hope despite this being a very dark movie, but it's, I mean, when I say dark, there's torture, there's nightmare visions, there's Luke losing limbs, there's betrayal, but it never gets too dark, and there's always hope there, and the ending is very somber and downbeat, yet somehow there's still hope. And that's really difficult to pull off, and really difficult to surpass what came before it. And there's so many iconic moments in this movie. Luke and Vader's battle is just, the battle itself is iconic. Vader's admission to Luke about who he really is, iconic. It changed cinema. This entire movie changed cinema. Leia telling Han Solo she loves him, and then his cocky response despite the fact that he knows he's doomed. Luke training with Yoda, Luke trying to lift the X-Wing out of the swamp. Just a perfect, perfect movie, and the movie changed cinema. It changed how people looked at sequels. People wanted better from sequels after this movie. I can't think of a single fault in this movie. I can pick something out of every other movie in this trilogy. I can't pick anything I didn't like in this movie. The effects were great, the sound was great, everything about it just worked, it fitted. This is one of those perfect, perfect movies, and it made everything that come after it a really tough pill to swallow, that they could never top this. And I'm genuinely gutted that this was the best it got. So this movie, it was perfect. It was an absolutely perfect movie. I can't think of anything bad with it. There's nothing I don't like. I can't find a fault in this movie, whereas I can find something in all of the others that I don't like. There was just a perfect, perfect movie. And it changed cinema. It changed cinema for the better. And deservedly, this is number one. So guys, that was my Star Wars ranking list. Let me know in the comments down below what your own lists are. And don't just put the order. You know, have a bit of a conversation, because I know some of these movies are going to be in the wrong order to you, but it's all down to personal taste. I expect everyone's list will have The Phantom Menace at the bottom of the list, because it was shit. Guys, thank you very much for tuning in. Like, comment, share, subscribe, and I hope you enjoyed my list. Goodbye.